Om Namah Shivaya students. In this video, we will read the short story, The Summer of the Beautiful White Horse. I will discuss this short story in details. In the last video, while telling you all the summary of the short story, I had told that this story is about two Armenian boys, Aram and Morad, who belong to the Garoglenian family. Their tribe is known for their honesty. They are poor and can hardly earn money for food. They both long to ride a horse. Morad had stolen a horse from a farmer a month ago. One early morning, he brought it to the window of Aram and asked him to come along for a ride. They rode the horse for many days. When Aram gets to know that the horse is stolen, he gets shocked but discounts the stealing in his mind. One day, the owner of the horse, John Byro, comes to his house to complain about his missing horse to Uncle Khosrow. One day on their way back to hide the horse on the deserted vineyard, they meet the owner and feel guilty at the end. The next morning, they return the horse back to the owner's barn. Now, we will read the story in details. As I'll read the story, you will also read the story along with me. You will take a pencil in your hand. When I'll tell you to mark the important lines, you will do the same. The Summer of the Beautiful White Horse, written by William Saroyan. One day back, there in the good old days, when I was 9 and the world was full of every imaginable kind of magnificence, ant life was still a delightful and mysterious dream. My cousin Morad, who was considered crazy by everybody who knew him except me, came to my house at 4 in the morning and woke me up, tapping on the window of my room. One day, 9-year-old Aram was asleep and he was in a world of extremely beautiful imagination. His life was pleasant and kind of in a mysterious dream. His cousin Morad showed up on the window of his room at 4 in the morning. "Aram," he said. I jumped out of bed and looked out of the window. I could not believe what I saw. His cousin Morad called him and Aram jumped out of his bed, and when he looked out of the window, he could not believe what he was seeing. It wasn't morning yet, but it was summer, and with daybreak not many minutes round the corner of the world, it was light enough for me to know I wasn't dreaming. Aram, who jumped out of his bed, when he looked out of the window, he could not believe what he was seeing. It was dawn and there was light enough outside for him to realize that what he was seeing, actually he wasn't dreaming. My cousin Morad was sitting on a beautiful white horse. I stuck my head out of the window and rubbed my eyes. "Yes," he said in Armenian, "it's a horse. You are not dreaming. Make it quick if you want to ride. Make it quick if you want to ride." So what did Aram see that morning when he looked out of the window? He saw his cousin Morad, who was sitting on a beautiful white horse. Aram stuck his head out of the window and rubbed his eyes because he still could not believe what he was seeing. "Yes," Morad said in Armenian, "it's a horse. You are not dreaming. Make it quick if you want to ride." So Morad was sitting on this white horse. Aram rubbed his eyes and stuck out his head out of the window, and Morad assured him that he was not dreaming. And he also told him to make it quick if he want to ride the horse. I knew my cousin Morad enjoyed being alive more than anybody else who had ever fallen into the world by mistake, but this was more than ever I could believe. When Morad asked Aram that if he wanted a ride, he must make it quick, Aram said that he knew that Morad was a type of person who enjoyed being alive, but still he could not believe that he was actually seeing a horse in front of him. In the first place, my earliest memories had been memories of horses, and my first longings had been longings to ride. Aram's earliest memories was of horses, and he always wanted to ride one. Okay, this was the wonderful part. That was the wonderful part, that he was actually going to ride a horse for real. So it was in Aram's memories that he had longed to ride a horse. Okay, Aram's first longings had been longings to ride a horse. And the most wonderful part was that Aram was actually seeing a horse in front of him. So he became very excited to see the horse, because he wanted to do this horse riding for a long time, but he could not do it. But for the first time today, or that day, he was seeing a horse in front of him. In the second place, we were poor. This was the part that wouldn't permit me to believe what I saw. We were poor. We had no money. Our whole tribe was poverty stricken. So Aram said that he could not believe for two reasons. Number one, horse riding and real horses, they were in his memories. He had always imagined, but he had never seen a real horse in life. That was the first reason. And the second reason was that they belonged to a tribe who were very poor. Okay? And that did not permit them to actually believe that a real horse is standing in front of them. Means he could not believe that anyone of his tribe could actually buy a horse, because they were very poor. We had no money. Our whole tribe was poverty stricken. Every branch of the Garigalanian family was living in the most amazing and comical poverty in the world. Aaron's tribe was very poor and they had no money, so it was actually difficult for him to believe in what he saw outside his horse. Outside his house. That is, he actually could not believe that he was actually seeing a horse in front of him. He belonged to the Garigalanian family, and that tribe was strictly and funnily, they suffered from poverty. Okay? They were living in that most amazing and comical poverty in the world. So that Garigalanian tribe, they were very poor and they suffered from poverty. Nobody could understand where we ever got money enough to keep us with food in our bellies, not even the old men of the family. They did not even know how they managed to get food for themselves every day. Okay? Most important of all, though we were famous for our honesty, though they were very poor, the tribe was extremely famous for their honesty. Underline this line. We had been famous for our honesty for something like 11 centuries. So for 11 centuries, this tribe had been famous for their honesty. Though they were very poor, though they did not have enough money to buy food every day, still they were famous for honesty. Okay? Even when we had been the wealthiest family in what we like to think was the world, we were proud first, honest next, and after that we believed in right and wrong. Now Aram said that although his tribe was poor, they were known for their honesty for 11 centuries. They were honest, they were proud, and they always believed in right and wrong. None of us would take advantage of anybody in the world, let alone steal. So no one from their family would ever steal anything or would ever take advantage of anyone in the world. Consequently, even though I could see the horse, so magnificent, even though I could smell it, so lovely, even though I could hear it breathing, so exciting, I could not believe the horse had anything to do with my cousin Murad or with me or with any of the other members of our family, asleep or awake, because I knew my cousin Murad could not have bought the horse, and if he could not have bought it, he must have stolen it, and I refused to believe he had stolen it. Very important, all these lines underlined. So Aram was very excited to see that horse. Okay, that horse looked very beautiful. Aaron could actually smell it and hear it breathing, but still he says that he could not believe that Morad or anyone in the family could afford a horse. He now thought that Morad had stolen the horse, because actually Morad or anyone of the family could not afford a horse because they were very poor. But he still did not believe it, that Morad had stolen her horse, as he knew that no one in the family could be a thief. No member of the Geroglenian family could be a thief. I stared first at my cousin and then at the horse. There was a pious stillness and humor in each of them, which on the one hand delighted me and on the other frightened me. Aram was thinking if Morad had actually stolen the horse, because he knew that Morad could not steal a horse because no one in his family could ever be a thief. So he stared at his cousin and then at the horse. There was religious motionless and wittiness in both Morad and the horse, as one charmed him and the other scared him. Got it? Morad, I said, where did you steal this horse? Leap out of the window, he said, if you want to ride. It was true then. He had stolen the horse. There was no question about it. He had come to invite me to ride or not, as I choose. Aram asked Morad if he had stolen the horse. Morad replied that if he wanted to ride the horse, he must jump out of the window. Aram was thus convinced that the horse was stolen by Morad. He had come to visit him to ask him to go for a ride with him. And yes, Morad had actually come to invite him to go for a ride with him. And it was on Aram that he will go for the ride or not. Well, it seemed to me stealing a horse for a ride was not the same thing as stealing something else, such as money. For all I knew, maybe it wasn't a stealing at all. Now, Aram said that he thought that this particular act of stealing would not be called stealing until they decide to sell it. Okay, so he says over here that it seemed to me stealing a horse for a ride was not the same thing as stealing something else. So he justified that this stealing of a horse is actually not a stealing, because it's not the same thing as stealing something else such as money. Okay, for all he knew that maybe it wasn't stealing at all. If you are crazy about horses the way my cousin Morad and I were, it wasn't stealing. So he was justifying himself by telling that this act of stealing a horse was not at all a normal act of stealing, like stealing some money, because they, both these cousins, they were mad or they were crazy about riding a horse. And that wasn't stealing at all. It would not become stealing until we offered to sell the horse, which of course I knew we would never do. So Aram justified this act of stealing by saying that this isn't a normal act of stealing until they decide to sell the horse, which they would never do. Okay? Let me put on some clothes, I said. All right, he said. But hurry, I leaped into my clothes. I jumped down to the yard from the window and leaped up onto the horse behind my cousin Morad. So Aram wanted to put on some clothes, and in a hurry he put on some clothes and he jumped out to the yard from the window and leaped up onto the horse behind his cousin Morad to go for a ride. I'll end my class over here. In my next video, I'll again continue with the explanation of this short story. Till then, thank you. Om Namah Shivaya.